What do you do if you opted to do chromosome testing on your embryos during IVF and they all came back abnormal? Should you stop trying because further IVF attempts would be futile? Or should you keep going in the hopes that a future attempt may produce one or more normal embryos? A new study has helped us to answer those questions. Stay tuned. Hi, I am here at the annual meeting of the American Society for Reproductive Medicine, along with hundreds of fertility specialists from around the world. Most of the embryos that human beings produce are abnormal, meaning that they do not have the ability to produce a live birth. One of the most common abnormalities is when an embryo does not have the correct number of chromosomes. Doctors refer to this as aneuploidy. We have known for some time all women produce chromosomally abnormal embryos, but that older women produce more abnormal embryos than younger women. During IVF, we have the ability to test embryos for aneuploidy. This is referred to as pre-implantation genetic testing, or PGT for short. If you look at the percentage of abnormal embryos produced by women of different ages, you will find, as expected, that the percentage of abnormal embryos is higher when the eggs come from older women. For example, at my IVF center, if we look at women under the age of 32, we find about 40% of the embryos we test are abnormal. If we look at 38 to 40-year-olds, we find that over 60% of the embryos are abnormal. Where does that 60% number come from? Hundreds of couples produce thousands of embryos that are tested. If we add up all of the embryos from all of those couples, over 60% of them are abnormal. However, if we look at each individual couple, we find some couples on a given IVF cycle will have 0% abnormal embryos. Other couples will have 100% abnormal, and still other couples will have some percentage in between. Is this just random chance? Or do some couples have a specific problem that makes them more likely to produce all abnormal embryos? If that were true, then we would counsel those patients that they should stop trying or use donor eggs or donor embryos. Recently, doctors here in the USA did a study. They looked at 538 couples who had all of their embryos come back abnormal in their first IVF, but who returned to do a second attempt. They found that 56% of those couples had at least one normal embryo in their second attempt. Those couples who did not find a normal embryo in their second attempt were on average 3 years older, had less eggs, less embryos, a lower percentage of embryos that reached the blastocyst stage, and less embryos that could be tested. In fact, those couples who did have a normal embryo on their second attempt had, on average, 3 embryos to test compared to 1 in those that didn't. Overall, women under age 37 had more than an 80% chance of obtaining a normal embryo in their second cycle. In contrast, only 25% of women aged over 42 years were able to get a normal embryo. However, in older women who produced at least 3 embryos for testing, about half were able to produce a normal embryo in their second attempt. Finally, when the researchers looked at the chance for a live birth, couples that had an embryo for transfer in their second attempt had a similar live birth rate to those who were able to transfer a normal embryo in their first attempt. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. Don't be too discouraged if all of the embryos in your first IVF attempt were abnormal. There is still a pretty good chance for finding normal embryos with a subsequent attempt, especially if you are younger or have many embryos to test. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.